اوكي. هلو اروى معايا توا. You are with me now. Okay, good. Clear, the sound is clear. Yes, alhamdulillah. So look on this PPT, please. You can inform the other. Merci, Hela, Allah yakhlik. If you have the possibility, inform the other because we have 25 minutes now later, okay? I will write just one message. The session is on now for the other. Okay, so look on this PPT. We study the different management theories. Okay, you can ask me at any time. This usually the same structure, the different questions that we try to answer through this or during this session. What's the payoff in studying different management perspectives both yesterday and today? So we can understand here that we have two group of approaches, management of yesterday and management of today. Donc, take this in your mind, please, and take note in the same time, okay, in explaining this each slide. Second question. If the name of the game is to manage work more efficiently, what can the classical viewpoint teach me? So we have here the first approach, the classical viewpoint. Okay, what? A teacher, Munemoj, what can I do? So 1 minute, what can I do for Mona? I must try again. I must open the lunch. What I can do for just 1 minute, Livnet, Lahza Barka. Oh, Yamuna, Yamuna. No, not this. Can I do with Mona, Ya Rabbi? So here, just 1 minute, Lipnet, to open the another lunchroom. So I must upload on the course of administration. But I think that Mona, I can't open for her another. I must create another lunchroom now. Wait, Allah Ghalib, اليوم عنا شوية إشكالية. I can't for Mona. Really, I can't. I have a problem. Really, I can't. But I try. Tools. She hasn't session, so I must create for her now the session. I can't. Just message for one. She can. You can. واحدة من البنات هلا. Please inform Mona that I can't open. عندي problem of internet. مش سريعة بالكل internet عندي. Okay. قولي لها راح تجد السيشن موجودة ريكورد ويلزمها تحل مشكلتها عنها تغير الانسكريبشن ويز يو بليز. قولي لها دكتور سميرة مو قادرة تحل لك اللانش روم ناو بليز. هلا الله يخليكي. اوكي اوكي ثانكس. So we continue now. Say him quickly. We continue now. So we have management of yesterday. Management, the contemporary management. Second question two, classical viewpoint. So we have a classical viewpoint about management. Question number three, to understand how people are motivated to achieve, what can I learn from the behavior? So look here, we have another approach called as the behaviorist or the behaviorism. Okay? So take this on your mind, please. Question number four now. If the manager if the manager's job is to solve the problems, how might the two quantitative approaches help? So here you have two quantitative approaches. Another approach for the management, which the characterization of this approach. Question number five. How can the exceptional manager be helped by the system viewpoint? So we have another approach, the system viewpoint. Okay? Question number six now. Is there one best way to manage in all situations? Here you will see that we have another approach linked to the situation or contingency. Okay, contingency approach. Question number seven now. Can the quality management view point offer guidelines? So you have another approach called as quality management viewpoint also. Okay? For true managerial success, and finally, how do I build a learning organization? Look, each question is about an approach. But follow me, how we can divide the different approach and classify the different approach. Starting by this topic, evidence-based management. What's the objective? Is to translate principles based on best evidence into organizational practice. So, باش نخرجوا من النظري, okay, to pass to the practice. So, this is very important to study these different theories, these different approaches. Okay, because manager can based on these approaches to make the organizational practice. Okay, if you have a question, you can ask me. Okay, so this is the first. معني أهمية this said by Sutton. Pfeffer, Sutton. شقال, translating, how can I translate the principles based on the best evidence on these theories on organizational practice. Okay? Clear? Amjad, Arwa, Aida, clear? يزمكم تتابعوني. Okay? I need some concentration with me for this chapter. Good, good. So, look here. We have two perspectives about management. And take note, please, in the same time. Two perspectives. The first is the historical perspective. And in this perspective, we find different viewpoints called as classical, behaviorist, and quantitative approach. So we have now two types of perspectives. So we have historical perspective and contemporary perspective in which we find the systems management focused on the system, contingency, and the third approach, quality management. Clear or not clear? So now we have, you must follow me, follow this idea. We have two big perspectives about management, the historical perspective and the contemporary perspective. Looking now for to the objectives. I pass quickly. Looking now in this fugue summarizes the different perspectives or the two perspectives with the different approaches. But here we start by the classical viewpoint. The classical viewpoint. Look here. We have here, when we say classical viewpoint, look on this first column. Number one. When we say classical viewpoint, this is the first approach for the first perspective. Now, the first approach for the first perspective, which is the historical management or perspective. For this classical viewpoint, is to study ways to manage more work more efficiently. This is the purpose of this approach. How to manage the work more efficiently. And in this approach, we find two other approaches called as scientific management and administrative management. So, with the scientific management, we have the proponent, the big boss, is Taylor. And also, we found Gilbreth. So, we have two proponents or founders for this approach, called as named scientific management. But what the basic theory of this approach? Look. For Taylor, emphasis scientific study of work methods, and note, this, the work methods, how to study the work methods to improve productivity of individual worker. يلزمكم تعرفوا كل شيء, تعرفوا each proponent and his approach and his basic idea or thinking, his thinking, okay? For Taylor and Gilbreth, proponent of this approach named scientific management, the thinking, study the work methods. Why? Which manera? The best work methods to apply and this to improve productivity of individual workers. Okay? Clear or not clear? For Taylor. Alhamdulillah. Good. Aida, clear? Okay. Now, usually with the classical viewpoint, administrative management. And when we say administrative management, we say proponent Fayol, the big boss, and also Max Weber. Okay? So, for Fayol and Max Weber, thinking about how to manage the total organization, not just the work, not specify here. This for the total organization. How divide the activity of total organization. So, here we have two approaches called as classical viewpoint. The first thinking is of Fayol, Taylor and Gilbreth, saying that how to find the good work methods to improve productivity of individual workers. The second, named administrative management for Fayol and Weber, how to manage the total organization. Clear? This number one. Now, usually with the historical perspective, and we have the second group of approaches called as behavioral viewpoint. And here's the question. Teacher, why is called behavior? And I will explain after this. Because the النقد اللي توجه للفيرست ابروش كلاسيكال فيو بوينت is that called worker or person as a machine. Okay? Here the second approach developed to give importance to the person, to the worker, to look on the behavior worker. Okay? Clear, Libnet? So look here. Emphasis on importance of understanding human behavior and motivating and encouraging employees towards achievement. لهنا اهتم اكثر بالbehavior of the workers. عكس opposite to Taylor and Fayol for the classical viewpoint. And for this approach, we find under approaches the earlier behaviorist and the proponent are Mansberg, Follett, and Mayo. Second, we find human relation movement and this proposed better human. This is based on the human relation. Okay? And the proponents are Maslow and McGregor. And we, inshallah, study at the following the theories of Maslow, pyramid of Maslow, and the theory of McGregor. And finally, behavioral science approach, which is based on the science, okay, to look on the behavior of the worker. Clear? Have you question? Before studying quantitative, the third approach for the historical perspective. Alhamdulillah. Okay. سهام واضح، أمجاد واضح، فاتيمة، حنان، مشاعل، كلير، منيرة، نورة، كلير؟ أوكي، سو ناو، أوكي، الحمد لله، أوكي، سو ناو، فور ذا كوانتيتاتيف فيو بوينت، أبلايز، أوكي فاتيمة، أبلايز كوانتيتاتيف تكنيكس تو مانجمنت. So here واضح. The title واضح. And applies quantitative techniques like mathematics and everything to the management. And we find here two other approaches called as management science, which is focuses on using mathematics and other techniques to solve the decision making. And the second approach called as operations management, which is the focus on the managing of production. Okay? And how to produce products and services more effectively. So, هذا الكل read to this figure, this for the historical perspective. And we will look after the contemporary perspective. So now we develop each approach. But we start by this. What means the muhadatha al-khassa, Munira? I don't understand. Tshufi, what means muhadatha al-khassa? I don't understand. I don't understand you, Muni. Hey, you can write your question. Shuf Kolshi. For example, Kada Shufi Kinti. When you want to ask question, ask question. No problem. تحبي تكلميني directly? كلميني. عطيتك تحبي تدخلي تكلميني without chatting? كلميني. I give you some minutes. Ask me directly. هني نسمع. وإلا write your question. I don't understand you, Munira. Okay, thanks. If you have a question, أنا نشوفها. ما فما حتى مشكلة ونجم نجاوب without معناها نقول الاسم. Okay, ما في ولا مشكلة. So look for the وحاجة بركة please إذا كان أنا فاهم صح. Please. Ask your questions. ما فيش حتى حد في الدنيا هذه عنده كل المعلومة حتى your doctor. Okay? Ask your question من غير حشمة. حشمة معناها من غير حسابات. Without, okay, computation. So ask your question and I can answer without saying the name. No problem. Okay? Clear? فهمت ولا ما فهمت؟ Clear? Okay. So now, which, good. Which viewpoint emphasizes the scientific study of work methods to improve the productivity of individual worker? Look here. Which the viewpoint that study what? The work methods. Okay? The work methods. To, of course, Aida, good, of course, is in the red. Answer A is the scientific management and the proponent is the big boss Taylor. Okay, so here Taylor study the work method. Look, little questions during the different slides, presenting in these different slides can be also a question on the exam. Okay, like I send you, you have received today my PPT for questions. Yes, so this also can be also question multiple choices on the exam. Look now, who has studied the work methods, of course, is the scientific management and not administrative management or behaviorist or quantitative management, okay? We continue now. What about this scientific management? Study the scientific work methods to improve the productivity of individual worker. هاني عاودت حللت لكم. So each slide is to study each approach اللي موجود in the figure. Okay? So, for Taylor now, what the principles of scientific management? One, scientifically study each part of the work, and this is the key word. Each part of the work or of the task. So here, looking on the details. Each part of the task. Not this, please. This for Taylor for scientific management. Number two, carefully select work with the right abilities. So, how الإنسان المناسب في المكان المناسب. So how to select the good worker with the right abilities. Looking on the experience and the competence. Okay? Question number, principle number three. Give workers the training and the incentives to do the task. So here, training and motivation incentives to do the task. And four, use scientific principles to plan the work methods. Okay, so scientific principles to plan for the work methods. Okay, these the different principles of Taylor thinking or of scientific management. Have you question? Hala, have you question? Mashaal, Munira, هذوما اللي مقابليني. Aida, okay, clear? Amjad, ستعرفوا قعدت في قلبي شو اسمها هي نسيتها، نسيت اسمها الأخرى اللي تستحق نظر لنشوم، والله قعدت في قلبي. So we continue. Clear؟ عائشة، أمل، أروى. Clear؟ We continue. This for scientific management. Now for administrative management. Good. الحمد لله. Good. Now when we say administrative management, we say Henri Fayol is a French engineer. Henri Fayol هو مهندس فرنسي. Okay. And is the first to identify the يعود له الفضل the major functions of management. So Henri Fayol, the first to identify the major functions of management. And what about now his thinking? For Fayol, he concerned with managing the total, not details here. Opposite in Taylor. Here, the total organization. This the thinking of our big boss, Henri Fayol. Proponent or founder, Fayol. Okay? How to manage the total organization. وذلك على جد the term administrative management. Okay? Looking on the administrative of this organization. We continue now. For Max Weber, and also Max Weber is another proponent for the administrative management, like Fayol. Okay? So, for Max Weber, he believed on the bureaucracy. And saying that bureaucracy was rational, efficient, ideal organization based on the principles of logic. So for Max Weber looking and also Fayol looking on the bureaucracy. So how divide the organization on different activities. Each person has his office, has his task. Okay, so is very rational to do this, very also efficient to do this. This the thinking. Yes, yes, either good. Yes, this in Arabic. Yes, the same. This translation. A good translation on Arabic. Good. Okay? I'm also with you. So, هذه اللي نقولوا لها البيروقراطية هيك in Arabic. So, how to divide the work. Good. Now, the five positive future, bureaucratic features. Okay? Features. What these five advantages? One, a well-defined a hierarchy of authority. This is the first advantage. And look on this figure اللي قدامكم ولا الفوتو اللي قدامكم. Okay? So, how to define the hierarchy? أنه الرئيس الأعلى وتحت 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 في حد الموظف أقل موظف. Second, formal rules and procedures. Everything is indicated and communicated by writing or by written. Okay? So here, formal rules and procedures. A clear division of labor. تقسيم العمل واضحة. Impersonality and carries based on merit. This the five positive bureaucratic features. Okay? Clear? Usually with Fayol and Max Weber. What now is the problem of this classical viewpoint? Thinking of Taylor, scientific management, and of Fayol and Max Weber for the administrative approach. The problem with this approach is mechanistic. What means? Call it the worker or the human as a machine, not taking into account the importance of human needs. هذا ما يعيب على هل thinking of Taylor, Atayon and Gilfred. So look, not taking in the account the importance of the human needs. Okay, so looking on the worker as a machine. ما يهموش فيه زعلان مو زعلان, satisfied not satisfied. So you work, you have your task, you must working and taking at the end of the month your salary and stop. Not long looking on the human needs. This is the problem of class. Take this on your account. Why? And take note, please. Because just after this approach, we find the behaviorist and the behaviorist approach. Okay? So just after the classical viewpoint, we have the behaviorist viewpoint. What now? We know that each theory has advantages and disadvantages. So what the important of this classical viewpoint, the work activity, how divide the work in different activity to be rational is a rational approach. Also, the application of scientific methods, time and emotion studies, and job specialization, it was possible to be productivity. Okay? These advantages of this theory, or of this first thinking of Taylor, Fayol, the different approaches. Okay? So we finish now with the classical viewpoint. And we pass to this question. Which viewpoint emphasizes the importance of understanding human behavior and of motivating employees toward achievement? Is scientific management? Of course, no. Administrative management? Look, human behavior. Administrative management? Of course, no. Behaviorist or behavior manager. Okay? This the right answer. Quantitative management, of course, no. Clear? Clear, Arwa? So we pass now to the second approach. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Good. The behavior viewpoint. Okay, good. So, what the thinking of this Fatima, this question for me? So, behavior viewpoint study the importance. No problem. Is recording. No problem. Okay? This virtual is recording. Okay? Good. So, behavior viewpoint study the importance of understanding human behavior and motivating employees toward achievement. So, looking on the I don't understand you. So, we continue. What's the behavior viewpoint? We have the three different principles. Early behaviorism, the first approach, the human relations movement, and the behavioral science. So, behaviorism, maybe you don't see three approaches, okay? So, we study the first. Formansberg and named father of industrial psychology, Mansberg, study jobs and determine which people are best suited to specific jobs. This first. Identify the psychological conditions, okay, under which employees do their best work. كما نقولوا نحن المحيط العمل اللي هو فيه. Okay. So, devise management strategies to influence employees to follow management interests. Look how Mansberg look on the psychology of the worker. Okay. Now, for fault. A so-called social worker and social philosopher. Organization should be operated as communities. Conflict should be resolved by having manager and worker turn over difference and find solution that will satisfy both parties. فيما بعضهم يتحدثوا فيما بعضهم find solution. Okay, resolved by having by talking, okay? The work process should be under control of worker with relevant knowledge. شوفوا لهنا كيف we give value to the human, to the worker, not like Fayol and Taylor, okay? Aisha, واضح؟ نورا منيرة مشاعر حنان clear this for fault okay ما ترقدوش please so what the Hawthorne effect now for this the early behaviorism good arwa so employees worked harder if they received هذه كي كونسبت اش معناها الكي كونسبت هذه means that employees worked hard if they received and added attention وقت اللي نهتموا به as a person as a human so he work harder okay so that the manager cared about their welfare and that the supervisor paid special attention to them this by Elton Mayo. Okay? So what he said, Elton Mayo, usually with the behaviorism. Now, look now on the second approaches for the behaviorism is based on the human relations movement. Proposes that better human relations could increase worker productivity. So we must looking on the relationships, okay? So said by Max Lowe and Mac Gregor. This is the theory of Maslow and Abraham Maslow and Douglas Mac Gregor. And we develop more this. For Maslow, this is the pyramid of Maslow or Maslow's hierarchy. What of needs, of course? For Maslow, present this pyramid to taking in account the different needs of the human, okay? And we start by this. This is the first need. Physiological need. What means physiological need, Hela, Hanan, Mashaal? البنات what means physiological need? This is the first need for the human. أروى عايشة what means physiological need? No answer? No? Fatima. Yes. Good. Good, Hela. Yes. So? Yes. Good. Good. متطلبات العيش. Food. Okay? Yes. Second, now need is safety, to be in security. Third need, social, esteem, to be esteemed, and self-actualization. So you must look on these different needs classified by Maslow, the big boss Maslow. Now for MacGregor and for this behaviorist also, we have two types of theory. Theory X represents a pessimistic or negative view of work. معناها شنو هو عندك انت معتقد الداخل, what you believe for this person. فيها عباد عندها negative view point. This تاخذي البليف الاول, the first belief هو negative appreciation. So this called theory X. So this belief is very important and I will show you why. Looking, what means negative view? Means that in your belief, this worker is not responsible, is not resistant to change. Yes. Yes, عايد, الله يخليك, النظرة السلبية. Yes. Not ambition, not. Okay, all negative view. The second theory, why? Represent an optimist, the opposite. Means positive view. Your first belief is a good appreciation. Looking on this worker as responsible, okay? As self-direction, as self-control, as being creative, okay? So this the theory of MacGregor. And look here, these theories. أنك أنت هالبليف اللي عندك can help managers understand how their beliefs affect their behavior. You look كيفاش أنت المعتقد والنظرة اللي عندك الأولى can affect your behavior. If your belief is negative, so your behavior will be negative for this person, or through this person, to this person. When your belief is positive, so your behavior will be also positive to this person. Okay? This what the importance of this theory. Also, managers can be more effective by considering how their behavior is shaped by their expectations about human nature. Okay? And we finish with this approach called as behaviorist. Okay? Look now, just 1 minute. Look now for the last approach, behavior science on one statement. This approach relies on scientific research for developing theories about human behavior. يلتجأ ديما للعلوم ليلقى الحلول وال provide practical tools for the manager. Okay? Now, what about the third viewpoint, quantitative viewpoint? And here we find management science and operations research. We find two under approaches for the quantitative viewpoint. مضيعوش. Usually with the historical perspective, okay? And with the last group of approaches. Quantitative management. Application of management of quantitative techniques such as statistics, computer simulation, okay? This for the management science. For this call, so we have the management science first, and we have the second approach, operations management. What's the difference between these two approaches? Look here. For the management, we start by this question. Which viewpoint stresses the use of rational, science-based techniques, mathematical models, to improve decision-making and strategic planning? Scientific management, of course, no. Operations management, we will see now. Production management, now. This is the management science. Management science, and I explain now. Management science is based on the use of the rational, of the techniques, of the mathematics, of the different scientific models to improve decision making. يعتمد على كل ما هي العلمانيات الأمور العلمية. Okay? Clear or not clear, البنات؟ ما دختو دختو ولا ما دختو؟ So, إن شاء الله باش نكملكم. Good, good, good. الحمد لله. Good. So now for operations management is focuses. هلا good. Is focuses on managing the production and delivery of animals to our service more effectively. So here, for example, making work schedule, production planning, facilities, location, and design. كل ما تطلبه ال production. This the operations management. And we finish now with this historical perspective to start by the contemporary perspective. نخلي لكم المجال أنكم تقرأوا هذا the new. And we have here three approaches. I explain the figure. All these approach or perspective with this figure. I explain this figure. نخلي لكم أقرأوا. If you have a question on the Facebook, ask me to continue with our course. So what about the system? Here for the contemporary perspective, we find three approaches. The system is viewpoint, the contingency viewpoint, and the quality management viewpoint. Okay? And for the last approach, we find quality management by quality control, quality management by quality assurance, and quality management by total quality management. Different methods using in this last approach. What the mean of the system viewpoint? Regards the organization as a system. And when we say system, say different parts linked and having interrelation, intercoordination, between these different parts. So the first viewpoint, look on the organization as a system. As a system of interrelated parts that operate together to achieve a common purpose. A common purpose is the specific purpose, is the fundamental purpose, is the organizational purpose. This the first approach. The second approach, الحالي, العصري. The contingency viewpoint. And why we say contingency? The related management in the situation, in the contingent. Look here. Emphasis that the manager's approach should vary, يتغير, change, according to, for example, contingent on the individual and environmental situation. So here, ما نقدروش نقولوا أن we have just one way to manage the organization. And this way is the fixed way. Now changing with this way during the time, during the years of the organization, during the life of the organization. Now, for this approach, you could now راهو ويك كان هاي كلمة نجم تفسر لنا update our management method or our management model to the situation. Okay, so what we can deduce, so what management can be varied, okay, and change during the time with the situation. And here, for this quality management, based on the quality. بأتم معنى الكلمة. So, we finish with this slide. البقية slide يفسر the system viewpoints, يزيد يحللها, يحلل the contingency viewpoint, ويحلل the quality viewpoint.